Hey everybody, it's your boy Nerdy Kane coming at you with a preview. The preview for Prophecy of the Wolf. They decided to go with Prophecy of the Wolf instead of something Beast because, I mean, you know everybody's into this box because of the new guys. I mean, the other guy, Wolfnar Ragbane, what's his name? I don't know. I'm kidding. Ragnar Wolf, Blackmane, sorry. I'm an orc player, what do you expect? We just got the preview for the box, and it is, aside from the two main characters, I'm hearing that it's kind of disappointing for people, because you get 10 Primaris Space Marines, and you get some Mega Knobs. You get 3 Mega Knobs and 5 Knobs, a Grot Oiler and an Ammo Runt, and you get the two main stars, the two divas of this box. I'm guessing this is probably going to be about $150 to $160 US. I don't know. They really haven't given us the price on this. They just previewed it on Sunday, and the pre-order is going to hit Saturday. So I'm not real sure what the price is going to be. That's what I think it's going to be, but don't hold me to it. A lot of people are a little upset because there's not really new models in it, and the models that are in it are kind of common, but I still think it's a good box, and I've said this before, I'm really new to this, so this is the first major release that I've been aware of that wasn't just like, you know, I came out when the Sisters first came out, and I was like, oh, okay, and it's, but now that I understand the way Games Workshop releases things, and the way they do things, I'm like, oh, that was a big deal. The Adeptus Sororita was really big, and this, the resculpt of Gaz is really big as well. I'm also very glad I didn't buy Gaz. I almost bought a Gaz the first day that I kind of got into this. That would have been a mistake because it would have been the old sculpt, and I would have realized later that I wanted to be a very heavy Evil Suns army. But it comes out, and yes, for the individual, it might be a little steep, a little much for, you know, you don't get it a whole lot for the price, but I kind of realized that there's a brilliance to the way Games Workshop does this and the way they releases it. They release it. They sort of do this, and I feel it's to promote cooperation and socialization between the players. If there's somebody who you think might be interested in getting into the game, or you yourself, you know, you can say, hey, why don't you? I want to do this. I want to have this type of army. I really like the Space Wolves. I really like the Orcs. Why don't you go in and split this with me? You'll get this really cool figure. I'll show you the game. You know, we'll have the connection of having this box together. So we got to get together and play. So it's sort of a social thing that for people who really can't afford to swing this thing on their own, go find a friend. Go find a good friend who's either into the game or might not be into the game. Bring somebody in. So I'm all about promotion of the hobby of this game. I really want to do that. I want to do things to promote it. I'm going to try not to get too negative because I came from a very negative fandom. I'm still in it. Comics. Comics is a lot of toxicity in comics right now, and that's why it feels so good to be here in the Warhammer 40K fandom. The setting is grimdark, but this is friggin' Disney World compared to the battlefield that comic books is right now, compared to the schism that Star Wars is dealing with right now. But I think it's a really interesting box. I'm gonna buy it. I don't know if I'm gonna put together maybe a small or small wolves army so I can have something else to play when I need a change, or let me know what you think in the comments. I may actually I may give this away. I may do a giveaway to where I'll set up a way to enter it, that way you get a number and you know the number, and then I'll do I'll build a program to do a random drawing, that way you get the, you know, you, and I'll do a video of that so you can see the actual drawing. But let me know if you guys think if you'd be interested in that. I may do a giveaway on that, a raffle giveaway on the wolves side of the army. But I'm still up in the air on that, but I am definitely not up in the air on getting this box. I am an Evil Suns player, but Gaz is just so big and so freaking cool that I really don't think I can pass up on this. I may have to go in on this. I'm definitely gonna have to go in on this, but it's a cool big box. It's a really big thing in Games Workshop that they've done in the lore. It makes me worry though if Gaz is gonna come out and he's gonna be this big. Are we gonna start to see, you know, if you know what the term power creep is, are we gonna start to see size creep in the 40K? Are we gonna start to see like orcs getting bigger and bigger? You see orcs the size of a tank, you know? Gaz is basically a big angry building with a gun and a claw. It's like fighting a building. Go check out the rules on him. Holy cow, the rules on him are crazy. He is gonna be, because he's the big bad thing, he can't take more than 4 wounds per phase. And that's a good thing, because Gaz is gonna be a big damage sponge. So I think a lot of players should build that into their strategy to use him as bait, because a lot of these other players, when they play against him, they're gonna see Gaz. He's gonna be the biggest figure on the battlefield. And they're gonna wanna remove him as quickly as possible. So you could probably build a strategy around that where you bait them. You bait them to go after him, and you have a way to pull him back and get him out of the fray. But that's just my thoughts on probably the proper way. Gaz should be like a home run hitter. Like at the end, he's the one who comes in the ninth inning and just is your bomb in the ninth inning, your late game bomb. But that's my thoughts on that. You guys let me know in the comments if you guys want to see me do a raffle on possibly the wolf side. I may do one for, because I want to get subscribers. I want to get my subscriber number up. I may start doing raffles on a weekly basis to do, maybe I'll give like a $20 Games Workshop e-gift certificate or something like that. But tell me what you think. Tell me if you think that's a good idea. If you guys have ever had channels to grow them, has that ever worked for you? But go check this box out. It is a good time. It's a fun time to get into 40K. If you're one of my comic book reader listeners, I should say watchers because it's a video format, but I think a lot of you guys watch or listen to my videos and other videos while you're doing something else, which is probably the proper way to do it. Because I'm not very visual. I'm not very much to look at. But yeah, tell me if you think that would be a good idea. Tell me if you'd be interested in that. And go check out the box. Go look into the game. And you guys go have a good day. Bye.